Chandler's not the type of guy who just goes to bars and makes out with girls. And you're right, Chandler's not the type of guy who just goes to bars and makes out with girls.
You kissed that guy!
In my defense, it was dark and he was a very pretty guy.
Well, I laughed so hard.
Oh, so hard we had to throw out your underwear again?
Whatever, dude. You kissed a guy.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey. Ooh, how's Hilda? Is she working out?
Oh, my new assistant is working out. Yes.
Was she happy you gave her the job?
Oh, my new assistant was very happy that I hired my new assistant.
Hello? Oh, hey. Can you hang on a second? It's the producers over at Mac and Cheese. Excuse me for a minute. Hey, funny you should call. I was just looking over next week's schedule. Canceled? Like, they're taking it off the air? Oh. All right. I'll see you Monday. We're not even shooting them anymore? All right. Bye. They canceled Mac and Cheese.
Sorry, Joey.
Why would they do that? It was a good show, right?
You want to tell secrets? Okay, okay. In college, Ross used to wear leg warmers.
Chandler entered a Vanilla Ice look-alike contest and won.
Ross came in fourth and cried.
Oh, my God!
Oh, is that funny? Oh, you find that funny? Well, maybe Chandler should know some of your secrets, too.
I already told him everything. You shush!
Once, Monica was sent to a room without dinner, so she ate the macaroni off a jewelry box she made.
Just practicing.
Ragtag. This is Phoebe. Phoebe, can I see you for a second?
Phoebe. That's a great name.
Oh, you like that? You should have my phone number. Okay. So, you hired yourself a little treat, did you?
I know how it looks for you trying to.
No, but you know you cannot get involved with your assistant.
Yes, I know that. I know that. And I know that hiring him was probably not the smartest thing that I've ever done. But I'm telling you from this moment on, I swear this is strictly professional.
Yes.
Hey, Rachel.
Hi.
Cute assistant. What's his story? Is he
gay?
Yeah.
Tribbiani. Surprised your big head could fit through our small halls.
I gotta go, Joey.
Wait, Terry, look, wait, look, I'm really sorry about before. I mean, I was an idiot thinking I'm too big to do this for you. You gotta give me another chance. I can't help you.
Wait, Terry, please.
Look, I just lost my other job, okay? You have no idea how much I need this. Please, help me out. For old time's sake.
This poor guy's been in a coma for 5 years. He's hopeless.
It's not hopeless. Dr. Stryker Ramore is a miracle worker. Look, here he comes.
Good morning. Drake, it's your brother Stryker. Can you hear me?
I'm back, baby!
There was no glitter on the macaroni and very little glue.
And in my defense, the cleaning lady came on to me.
You have no trouble telling time now, huh?
No.
Quick, what time is it?
I don't know. Time to get the guy, maybe? What are you laughing at, campers?
You know what I said? Because we're getting married, we should share everything and not have any secrets.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was stupid. Let's not do that.
Absolutely.
And we should keep all the stuff we told each other a secret from everybody else.
Definitely.
Okay. If you'll excuse me, I'm going to go hang out with some people who don't know the Space Mountain story.
Then I'd steer clear of Phoebe.
Not that you would, but I wouldn't hang out with all the guys in my office.
Hi.
Do you have a minute?
Well, yeah, sure. What's up?
I got asked out twice today while I was at lunch. By God. Someone that I was gay.
Oh, did you not want people to know that?
No, not gay. And I especially wouldn't want you to think I was gay.
Why is that?
I don't think I should say.
Oh, you can say. Come on, I don't want you to feel like you can't tell me things.
Okay.
Okay.
Well.
Yeah.
I'd love to ask out your friend Phoebe.
Yeah, she's gay.
Somebody on the subway licked my neck. Licked my neck.
Oh, Willie's still alive.
What are you guys doing?
Oh, my mom called. They're going to run our...
our engagement announcement in the local paper, so you're looking for a good picture of us.
Ooh, I'm afraid that does not exist.
That's not true. They're good pictures of us.
No, they're good pictures of you standing next to a guy who's going like this.
Oh, my God, that's the creep that you're with at the Statue of Liberty.
I don't know what it is. I just can't take a good picture.
Oh, that's a great one.
Yeah, I'm not in that.
No, but look at me all tan.
Hey, why don't you guys go get portraits done by a professional photographer?
It's a great idea. But they have one of those wind machines, Melanie.
Yeah, that's great. Next to that, Chandler won't look so stupid.
Chandler, what do you say?
All right, but I should warn you, I'm not going. I'm going.
To letting us play this time, too.
Look, Phoebe's talking to a cute coffee house guy.
Oh, you guys call him cute coffee house guy? We call him hums while he pees.
This one called Ross lingers in the bathroom.
Hey, you guys. Hums while he pees just asked me out.
Hey, I thought that guy was married.
He is, but he's getting divorced. Ross, maybe you know him.
It's not a club.
Phoebe, if this guy's going through a divorce, is it such a good idea to start going out with him?
Hey, divorced men are not bad men.
They have that on the napkins at the club.
Oh, I gotta get back to work.
You don't have to be back for a half hour.
Yeah, but my assistant Tag does sit-ups in the office during lunch. Oh, I could just spread him on a cracker.
If you have a crush on this guy, why would you hire him? I mean, you know you can't date him, right?
Oh, no, I know that. Although, we made a joke, though, that we spent so much time together, he should call me his work wife.
Soon he'll be able to call you that lady he knew that got fired.
I'm not going to get fired because I'm not going to act on it.
So then you wouldn't mind if he was dating someone else?
Why, is he? He is, isn't he? He's dating that slut in marketing.
I should open a divorce men's club.
Dude, that's so sad.
I could put a basketball court in the back.
Can I play?
Oh, no sit-ups today, Tag?
I just did them.
Oh, well, drop and give me 10 more. I had a drink with lunch. Did those, cost reports come in?
Yeah, I filled them out last night.
Oh, great. Could you make me 4 copies of those?
Sure.
Great, thank you.
Supervisor.
Monica?
Great.
Now, Chandler, you want to give us a smile?
Okay.
I'm sorry, is the seat uncomfortable?
No, I am.
Chandler, Taylor, sweetie, I know you can do this. You have a beautiful smile.
I can do?
Yeah. All right, maybe you don't have to smile. Let's try something else. Let's try, try looking sexy.
Okay.
Down the street, and I spilled sauce all over the front of my shirt. You got an extra one?
Yeah, sure.
Great. Anything that's not Ralph Lauren?
Yeah, I don't think so, Joe.
All right, I guess this will be fun.
Hey, listen, what are you doing tonight?
Not that much.
How would you feel about taking out my assistant tag? I'll pay.
Rich, I gotta say, it's gonna take a lot of money for me to go out on a date with a dude.
I'm not asking you to go on a date with him.
Really? Because I could kind of use the money.
No. Joey, he's new in town, and I know he doesn't have any guy friends. Just take him to, like, a ball game or something. I'd really appreciate it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Sure, thank you. Ooh, hey, donuts.
Yeah. I know. Let's try a look of far-off wonderment. Okay, we'll go gaze into our future, and we'll think about our marriage and the days to come. Chandler, what is the matter with your face? Wait, this picture is supposed to say Geller and Bean to be married, not local woman saves drowning moron. Hey, don't laugh at him. He's my drowning moron. That's it. Take it.
I like this one. It seems to say, I love you, and that's why I have to kill you.
It can't all be bad. Find the one where you make your bedroom eyes. Oh, there it is.
Oh, my God, those are my bedroom eyes? Why did you ever sleep with me?
Do you really want to pull at that thread? We're having a really good time.
Me too. Sorry that guy in the subway licked your neck.
Oh. No, that's okay. He's a friend.
I don't mean to be presumptuous, but I have these two tickets to the ballroom dancing finals tomorrow night if you want to go.
Yeah, I missed the semifinals, so I think I would just be lost.
Look, I know that it's really lame, but I got these tickets from my boss, and... Oh, no, my God.
Okay, don't freak out, I'll go.
My ex-wife Whitney is out there. I cannot deal with her right now. That woman is crazy.
Okay, I know. Hold on. Hey, Ross.
Yeah,
that's Whitney, Kyle's ex-wife out there. Now, do you think you could, you know, divert her so we could slip out?
What? No.
Well, okay, but I have two tickets to the ballroom dance finals.
I don't think so, Phoebs. All right, I'll do it. But just because you're a friend.
I just wanted to say thank you, though, for diverting Kyle's ex.
Oh, yeah, I know. You're welcome. Yeah. We'll talk about it later.
Okay.
Hi, Whitney.
Hi, Ross. Are you ready for breakfast?
Yep.
Kyle's ex-wife, you were supposed to divert her, not date her.
I am sorry. Can you give me a second while I talk to this woman, who, by the way, did not spend the night?
Sure.
Okay. I did divert her, and we ended up having a great time, okay?
Watching ballroom dancing?
Yes, that's where we realized we are both super cool people.
Well, look, okay, Ross. Kyle just told me some really bad stuff about her.
Like what?
Like, she's really mean, and she's overly critical, and no, she will paint a room a really bright color without even checking with you.
Okay.
And she uses sex as a weapon.
Fine, thank you for warning me. At breakfast, I'll be on full alert for room painting and sex weapons.
You're still gonna go out with her?
No.
Well, didn't you hear what I just said?
Phoebes, come on. I mean, consider the source. Of course her ex-husband's gonna say that stuff. Now, if you'll excuse me.
No, listen to me. She is crazy.
Your door isn't soundproof.
You see? Nothing is good enough for her. Did you have fun with Joey last night?
Oh, yeah. We went to the Knicks game.
Oh, that's nice.
And then we went out to this bar, and he hooked us up with all these women.
Women? You mean like old women?
Kind of old. Like 30.
Oh.
And I never used to be able to just talk to girls in bars, but I got like 20 phone numbers last night.
Oh, man, so Joey must have really taught you some stuff, huh? Yeah.
How you doing?
See? That's a great smile. Easy, natural.
Now pretend I have a camera.
Help it.
All right. You wanna know what I do when I take resume shots?
Borrow money from me?
Okay, first of all, you wanna make it look spontaneous, right? Okay, so here's what I do. I look down, keep looking down, then I look up. Ready? All right, now you try. Look down, you're looking down, keep looking down.
Why is there jelly on your shoe?
I had a donut.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, so, heard you had some fun with Tag last night.
Yeah, that guy's all right.
Yeah, and you had fun teaching him how to be all Joey.
What?
You know, all the women.
Hey, man, you can't teach someone to be good with women. You know, that's why I never had any luck with Chandler.
I'm right here.
All right, well, would you mind just not going out with him again? Okay, just the idea of you and he and all these women, and it just, and I know he's my assistant, and I can't date him, but it just bothers me, all right?
No, you can't take him away from me. I got a great partner to pick up girls with, finally.
I'm still right here.
All right, will you at least talk to him and tell him how hollow and unsatisfying this dating tons of women thing is?
What?
I just don't want him to meet anybody until I'm over my crush. And I will get over it. It's not like I love him. It's just physical. But, you know, I mean, I get crushes like this all the time. I mean, Ellie had a crush on you when I first met you.
I know, Monica told me.
Did you have a crush on me when you first met me? See me?
So, will you talk to him?
I don't know, Rage.
Oh, come on. I'll give you 10 free Ralph Lauren shirts.
One.
No, 10. You said 10. You can't take that back.
Hey, Joe. You want to talk to me?
I don't know. You got something for me?
Oh, yeah. This is from Rachel. not tagged, there's such a thing as too many women.
Really?
Yeah, for you.
Hey, there you are.
There I am.
Okay?
Yeah, Joey said I needed to relax, so he gave me an antihistamine.
What?
Yeah, and then I fell asleep on the subway and went all the way to Brooklyn.
Brooklyn is far.
Taylor, what were you thinking?
I don't know, but don't worry, because I know how to take a picture now. Okay.
Okay.
Look down. Look down. Look down.
Taylor?
Yeah.
Crazy. Has she cooked your rabbit yet?
No. Listen, you are hearing one side of the story, okay? And FYI, she must have shown Kyle over 30 paint samples before she painted that room. And his response to each one was, I don't give a tiny rat's ass.
Yeah, well, maybe she should have spent a little less time decorating and a little more time in the bedroom.
Well, I don't think we are going to have that problem, but maybe that's just because I am not emotionally unavailable.
You think he's emotionally unavailable?
I think he can be.
Well, maybe he wouldn't be if she didn't bring the office home with her every night.
Well, excuse her for knowing what she wants to do with her life.
Yeah, well, she certainly knew what she was doing New Year's Eve, 1997.
I knew you were going to throw that in my face. That was 3 years ago. She apologized and apologized. What more do you want?
We want the last 6 years back!
So do we! So do we!
I'm sorry you had to see that.
Morning, Rachel.
Hi. Hey, so, what'd you do last night?
Went out with Joey.
Oh, yeah? Another night, a bird dog in the chicas?
No. We had a really good talk. I don't think I'm gonna do that bar scene anymore.
Wow. I did not see that coming.
It's just not really who I am. You know, I've always been happier when... Why am I telling you this? You don't care about this.
No, yes, I do. Come on, go on. You're saying I'm happier when,
When I'm in a relationship. I love having a girlfriend.
Really?
Yeah, someone I can spoil, you know?
Spoil?
Let me ask you something.
Uh-huh.
Do you believe there's one perfect person for everyone?
I'm starting to.
And if that person's already in your life, you should do something about it, right?
Yes, hell yes.
All right, then, it's settled.
Okay.
I'm getting back together with my ex-girlfriend.
I would love to. Hello? Oh, yeah, this is going to be a while. Excuse me. In bed, how's Whitney?
Well, maybe she wouldn't have to be selfish in bed if someone else knew where everything was.
Oh, he knows. Minimus.
Oh, hey. Good, you're both here.
We kind of need to talk.
Both of you together?
Well, what's up?
Well, I went over to Kyle's last night to pick up a few things, and we got to reminiscing.
We talked through most of the night, and we realized that the reason we're so angry with each other is because there are still feelings there. So...
Oh, just say it, Kyle!
We're gonna give it another try.
What about her whining and her constant need for attention?
I'm going to work on that.
Oh, right, because you're so capable of change.
You know, he hums when he pees.
do know.
Makes him miss the bowl, but whatever.
We're so sorry.
That's all right. We don't need you. In fact, hey, I'm over it already.
Yeah, and you know what? I don't even give a tiny rat's ass.
Yeah, we're gonna go.
I'm sorry. Phoebes, you were right about her. You know, she did try to use sex as a weapon. Yeah, it hurt my back a little.
You know, he hums while he does other stuff, too.
Yeah, we're better off without them.
And you know, even if they break up again, you better not let him in your sad men's club.
Divorced men's club.
Potato, potato.
Hey, guys, check it out. My mom sent me the paper.
Good.
Well, you guys make a very attractive couple.
Yeah, we look great together.
We really do.
Okay.
Well, imagine what our kids would look like.
You know, we don't have to imagine.
I'm marrying her.
We'll just see.
You guys out to brunch today is because I've been doing some thinking about who should be my maid of honor.
Oh my god, this is it? Oh. I really hope it's you.
It's you.
Me too.
First of all, I love you both so much, and you're both so important to me.
Okay, blah, blah, blah. Who is it?
I was thinking that maybe we could come up with a system where we trade off being maid of honor for each other. Like, hypothetically, if Phoebe were mine.
Yes!
Hypothetically,
still.
If Phoebe were my maid of honor, mm-hmm. Rachel would be Phoebe's, I would be Rachel's. That way we all get to do it once and no one would get upset.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good idea.
Yeah, I'll do that. So who gets to be yours? Well, that's the best part. You guys get to decide.
Why is that the best part?
Because then I don't have to.
Well, of course. We will help you decide. We will do anything we can to help you. Okay, now I'd like to make a toast to the future, Mrs. Chandler Bing, my best friend, and truly one of the nicest people that...
Really nice. Fine. Excuse me, I couldn't help overhearing. You're marrying Chandler Bing?
Yeah, that's right.
Huh. Good luck.
Oh, and good luck to you, too.
What a nice lady.
Thank you.
get a double feature.
What else you're in?
Die Hard 2.
Joey, this is Die Hard 1 again.
Oh. But we watch it a second time and it's Die Hard 2.
Joey, we just saw it.
And
it would be cool to see it again. Yeah! Die Hard! Dude, you didn't say Die Hard. Is everything okay?
Yeah, I just got plans.
Well, John McClane had plans.
No, you see, the thing is, I want to get out of here before Joey gets all worked up and starts calling everybody bitch.
What are you talking about, bitch?
Hey, Rachel.
Yeah?
When I get married, will you be my maid of honor?
Really? Oh, my God, Phoebe. I mean,
wait a minute. If I'm your maid of honor, that means that you are Monica's.
Oh.
Well, if that's what you want.
Oh.
No, wait, Phoebe, I want to be Monica's.
But why does it even matter?
Why does it matter so much to you?
Because this one is now. And it's two of our best friends. Who knows what you're gonna marry?
What if I marry Ross? Or Joey?
You wouldn't. Okay, look, Rachel, I know you really want to do this, but I've never been maid of honor to anyone before, and I know you've done it at least twice.
Yeah, but
anyway,
Phoebe,
please let me finish. Oh, I guess that was it. Okay.
Since you've never done it before, you can be Monica's maid of honor.
Oh, thank you so much. Yay.
I'm going to marry someone good, you know.
Oh, I know.
Better than Chandler.
Well, is there any chance you were looking into a bright, shiny thing called a mirror?
Come on, was it someone maybe you dated in college?
No, I only dated two girls in college, both blonde, both not attractive. Hold on one second, let me check this out.
What are you doing?
Well, let's see. Okay, is that her?
Oh my God, yes! Who is she?
Julie Graff, my camp girlfriend.
Did you break up with her?
No, we're still together. Oh, yeah, we went out for two summers, and then I broke up with her.
Why?
Well, because she came back the third summer, and she'd gotten really fat.
Fat?
I did not say fat. I said fat.
You broke up with a girl because she was fat?
Yeah, but it was a really, really long time ago. Does she still feel bad?
Apparently, she does.
Well, you know what they say, elephants never forget. Seriously, good luck marrying me.
Phoebe is going to be Monica's maid of honor.
Hey. Well, I hope it goes better than the last time you did it for that girl downstairs, remember?
What? You have been maid of honor before? You see, this is exactly why you shouldn't lie. All right, that's it. I am maid of honor.
No, I am.
How come you are?
Because I cared enough to lie.
Hey, I can help you decide who should do it. Yeah, we could have like an audition and see how you'd handle maid of honor type situations.
What are you talking about?
Like when I want a job, I go to an audition. And if I'm the best of the people they see, they give me the part.
Okay, so after this audition, who decides who gets it?
Me and Ross could be the judges.
Well, it's better than us deciding.
Oh, come on, this is crazy. Can't we just flip a coin?
No, coins hate me.
Okay, fine. Noah, we will let Ross and Joey decide. Hi, Ross, sweetie. There, handsome thing.
Wow, this cologne really is every bit as good as Giorgio. Brought back your videos.
Ross, look, I think we need to talk about before.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do. Now, look, that was the best nap I ever had.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, admit it. That was the best nap you ever had.
Wasn't that better?
Okay, when?
All right, it was the best nap ever! I said it, okay? But it's over, Joey.
I want to do it again.
We can't do it again.
Why not?
Because it's weird!
Fine. You want something to drink?
Sure, what do you got?
Warm milk and Excedrin PM.
Chandler! Chandler, I just figured out who you are.
Can you figure out what I'm doing?
You're Louis Posen.
Who?
Louis Posen. He was my best friend in fifth grade. And then one day I asked him to be my boyfriend, and he said no. Do you know why?
Because you kept talking to him while he was trying to go to the bathroom.
No, but because he thought I was too fat. And every time I think about it, it makes me feel as bad as I did in fifth grade. You know, I really think that you should apologize to Julie.
Honey, are you kidding? That was like 16 years ago.
No, but you know, it would make me feel better if Louis apologized to me.
Okay, I will do it, but I have to warn you, this may make me a better person, and that is not the man you fell in love with.
All right, this is how it's gonna work. We're gonna give you hypothetical maid of honor situations, and you'll be scored on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the highest.
No, 10 is the highest.
Why is 10 the highest?
Because it's the highest. Okay, Rachel, you're up first. Situation number one. You're with Monica. The wedding is about to start when Monica gets cold feet. Go!
I don't want to marry Chandler.
Okay, it's gonna be okay.
One man the rest of my life? I don't know if I can do it. This means I'll never get to sleep with Joey.
Look, Monica. Getting cold feet is very common, you know? It's just because of all the anticipation. And you just have to remember that you love Chandler. And also, I ran out on a wedding. You don't get to keep the gifts.
Very good, drawing on your own experience. I like that.
Yes, very nice, Rachel.
Thank you, judges.
Oh, kiss ass. Oh.
Okay, Phoebe.
Yes, Your Honor.
We're now in the ceremony. Monica is about to say, I do, when her drunk uncle starts yelling. What do you do? Go!
When Monica was a little girl, I remember that... Oh! Very good!
Yes! Excellent! Perfect score!
Wait a minute! She just made a scene in the middle of the ceremony. Hey, you want a little taste of Phoebe's?
It's time for you to give your maid of honor
speech.
Oh, wait a minute. We haven't even prepared. Okay. Webster's dictionary defines marriage as a...
Yeah, no, forget that. That sucks. Okay, never mind.
I met Monica when we were just a couple of six-year-olds. And I became friends with Chandler when he was 25. Although he seemed like a six-year-old. I've known them separately and I've known them together, and to know them as a couple is to know that you are truly in the presence of love. So I would like to raise my glass to Monica and Chandler and the beautiful adventure they are about to embark upon together. I can think of no two people better prepared for the journey.
Wow.
It really was.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, Phoebe, I guess you're next, although I really don't see the point.
Okay. I can't believe that Monica and Chandler are getting married. I remember talking about this day with Rachel while we were showering together, naked.
She's back in the game.
Julie.
Hi.
Chandler Bing. I guess you remember me.